Hi everybody, in this video, we are going to learn how to attach a CloudWatch alarm to our Lambda function. We're going to learn this two ways. We're going to learn it through the AWS console, and then we're going to learn how to do this using serverless framework. So let's get started. Right now I'm in the AWS console for my sandbox environment, and I have no functions. So first we're going to create a function. And this is going to be really quick. I'm just going to make a function that errs out 50% of the time so that we can create an alarm that goes off when the function errs. So I'm going to create a function, erring Lambda. So what's going to happen is I'm going to let this response return successfully if it doesn't err. And in order to make this err out 50% of the time, I'm just going to say, if math.random is less than 0.5, then throw new error. Basically, math.random generates between 0 and 1, so if it's less than 0.5, which will be 50% of the time-ish, it will throw a new error. If this doesn't happen, it's going to respond successfully. And we can test this. So we can actually deploy this code. And if I click test, I can generate a new test really quickly. Doesn't need any inputs. We'll just save that test. If I click test, it errs the first time. Errs. Hello from Lambda. So you can see that it errs and it also successfully returns true. We want this to run a bunch of times. So I'm going to actually add a trigger and just put this on a schedule where it runs every minute. So I'm going to add our event bridge. And I do have an existing rule for every 1 minute. So I'm going to actually add that existing rule and then add. So now I have an erring Lambda function that runs every minute. What I want to happen is that when my Lambda function errs, I get alerted. So you can go back to your console. We can go to here. We could just search for a CloudWatch. Now in CloudWatch, there are a couple ways that you can set up an alarm. You can go over to your alarm section and we can create an alarm here. And this is what we're going to do. But you can also go into your metrics and explore. And then from there, you can actually start an alarm as well. But we're going to use the alarms. And if I look at my alarms, I actually have no alarms. So there's no alarms to display because this is just an empty account. So we're going to create an alarm and we're going to select the metric that we want to do. In this case, we have our erring Lambda and we know that metric is in Lambda. So I'm going to go in our Lambda and I'm going to look at my function name. And this is our erring Lambda. And I want to look at the errors. So the metric name that we're paying attention to is errors. Now there's a lot of other metrics that you can use. You can use concurrent executions, your invocations, how long it is. If you're provisioning concurrency, you can actually set alarms if it's over or underutilized. So there's lots of alarms that you can do for your Lambdas and in general, anything else like your ALBs or your auto scaling tools. In this case, we're obviously looking at how we can create an alarm for our Lambda specifically. So here's our erring Lambda. We'll select this metric. So we're going to specify the metric and conditions that we're going to do for this alarm. Basically, we're defining when will this alarm trigger. And it does a nice little graph here to show you that, give you a sample of that this alarm will trigger when our blue line goes above a red line. We don't have a red line yet because we haven't really defined what that threshold is, and that's below in the conditions. So in this case, we're looking at our errors for our erring Lambda, and we're looking at some statistics. So an average is like what the average of errors that occurred over the 5 minute period. It's not something that really makes sense. It's not really something that we want to look at. We actually want to look at the sum of errors. And this is the sum of errors in that period of 5 minutes. Now remember, our Lambda function is running every minute and it's got like a 50% chance of erring out. So we have these cases, it erred only 2 times, erred 5 times. It aired 3 times within that 5-minute window. So we're looking at this threshold and what we wanted to find from it. And we can use, basically, we can use a threshold type. We can have a static threshold type, or we can have an anomaly detection. Static is pretty self-explanatory. We can just say when, for like this value of this threshold, if it's greater than and equal to, let's say, 2, we want to go into an alarm state. The anomaly detection applies statistical and machine learning algorithms, and the algorithm continuously analyzes our metrics for our system and determines what the normal baseline is, and then it will surface what it considers anomalies with minimal user intervention. So for right now, we are going to do a static threshold type, but you can make a more complex alarm using anomaly detection. So we're going to have a static threshold type, and we're going to say that if it's greater than or equal to, actually we'll say 3, that we want to be alerted. Now, if this was a critical system and it couldn't err at all, well, you probably want to just say that if it's greater than 0, you need to be in alarm. So keep that in mind to determine what the criticality of your system is before, you know, when you're setting up these alarms. Now, there's an additional configuration. And with the additional configuration, you can set up data points to alarm that are defined within evaluation period that basically we're saying that they must be breaching to cause the alarm to go into the alarm state. And you also can determine missing data and how you would treat missing data. So if you were having a critical system, you probably don't want to just treat the missing data as missing or that it's good. You would probably want to say that it's bad or breaching so that you're alerted of this issue. So now we move on, and now we want to configure our notification. So the alarm has different states. This alarm has when it's in alarm, and it also has when it's okay, or maybe it has insufficient data because the alarm just started, or there's just not enough data in that time period. In any of these cases, you can have an SNS topic that the alarm then sends a notification to. So in the case here, I have an existing SNS topic, which is called my default CloudWatch Alarms topic, which emails to my endpoint. If you don't have this, you can just create a new topic, name what your new topic would be, and add the email address endpoint that would be at. When you add that email address here, you will get an email at that email address where they need to confirm subscription to the SNS topic. Now remember, we can have multiple alarms. So we can have the alarm that triggers when it's in alarm. We can also say that we want to trigger when it becomes okay, so we know that it recovered. And you can also make it where it's insufficient data as well. So this is pretty much the setup for our alarm. We have everything set up. We have the SNS topic that we're going to send our notification to. Then we want to name our alarm. We'll call this the airing Lambda alarm. And you can define a description for this alarm. We'll just call this example alarm. So here we have a summary of our metrics and conditions that we're doing when we're creating this alarm. So here's our metric. We're going off of the sum within the 5 period window. If it's greater than or equal to 3, we are going to put this in alarm. When it's in alarm, it's going to send a notification to our default CloudWatch alarms topic. And then we have the name and description of our alarm. So let's create this alarm. And our alarm has insufficient data because we just launched this alarm. It hasn't been around long enough to get in alarm. It will probably go in alarm any minute now. And there we have it. It's refreshed and it's now in alarm. So we would be receiving an email letting us know that our AWS alarm is in alarm. So here is the alert I received based to let me know that the CloudWatch alarm that I have is in the alarm state because it's crossed its threshold. So congratulations, you've just made a CloudWatch alarm using the AWS console. But now that we understand how to create this alarm using the console, let's translate this to attaching a CloudWatch alarm to our serverless framework YAML. So before that, I'm going to clean this up. I'm going to actually delete my function and delete my alarms so that we can start fresh in serverless framework. So now let's walk through how we would make this solution using serverless framework. Right here, I'm showing you the exact same function that I defined earlier using the Lambda console. And this function is airing out basically 50% of the time. If our map.random number is less than 0.5, we're gonna throw an error. Otherwise, we're saying hello from Lambda. Pretty simple. It's just so that we can hit our error threshold. Now, where we are defining our CloudWatch, alarm is using the serverless YAML file. So here I've defined our serverless YAML file already for us. We have our name of our service, the framework version that we're using, and then our provider and our runtime. This here is our definition of the function. So our function is named airing lambda. That's roughly the same name that we used when we did it in the console. And then we're just saying where the handler comes in, and we've scheduled the event to run every minute. So this is just how we schedule an event. Now, it doesn't have to be this case. You can have an API and it's being called ad hoc, and then, you know, you could handle your CloudWatch alarm how you want to there. We're just doing this so that we can hit our threshold pretty quickly so we can send out those alerts. Now, where we define our CloudWatch alarm is actually in the property called resources. And resources gives us the ability to use the CloudFormation template syntax in our serverless YAML file. CloudFormation has a really good definition already for our CloudWatch alarms, and there's no point in reinventing the wheel. So let's utilize what we already have. So using resources, we can then define the resources that are going to be used for our CloudFormation template. So in this case, we have three resources. We have our topic, which is the SNS topic, and we're going to call this the airing lambda alarm. And this just defines the fact that this topic is an SNS topic, and that we've also defined the topic name. Then we define our CloudWatch alarm. So this is where in the console we went into the CloudWatch and we created a new alarm. And then within there, that would be our type, right? The CloudWatch alarm. But then within there, we defined the alarm description. We defined what namespace we were looking at the alarm. We were looking under the AWS Lambda namespace. We defined the metrics. In that example, we were looking at the errors. Then we defined the statistic. Remember, there was average, there was max, there was min. We were looking at the sum over a 5-minute period. So we were saying if the sum was greater than or equal to 3, which was our threshold, then we wanted to alarm. We say that our comparison operator is greater than or equal to the threshold, which is 3. Within a 5-minute period. Periods are defined in seconds, so 60 seconds times 5 is 300 seconds. So that's why our period is 300. We also defined our missing data as breaching because we were considering this as a critical system. So if something was missing, we should probably just say it's breaching. Now we have our alarm action. Now our alarm action was where we had to notify our SNS topic. So that's where this SNS topic definition becomes important. So when our CloudWatch alarm goes in alarm, we are letting our SNS topic be alerted of this. Finally, we have to say the dimensions that this is around. Like if we made this alarm right now, it's actually not looking at any specific lambda. So we set the dimensions to our specific function name, which is airing lambda. And airing lambda is defined up here in functions. And that's how they connect the dots. So last but not least, our topic needs to have a subscription, and that's our SNS subscription. And in this case, our SNS subscription was an email endpoint. You could make your subscription actually be something like PagerDuty, and then you let PagerDuty be alerted so that you can then alert someone who's on the on-call rotation. So this is just the tip of the iceberg of a CloudWatch alarm. So here, I'm just having it send an email to me. This is how we define our serverless YAML, so that we can have a CloudWatch alarm go off and then send an email to me to be notified that our Lambda is airing too many times. So let's deploy this. So we would deploy this by using serverless deploy. And it's going to take a while, but once this is done, it will deploy to our account. So let's look for this in our account after it's done. All right, so it has successfully deployed. So let's look at our console now. And if I go to our Lambda, we should have our Lambda function successfully deployed. There it is. AWS Lambda CloudWatch example, dev airing Lambda. Yeah, it's a long name, but that's from our serverless deploy. We will have a new SNS topic. Remember, I had an existing topic already, which was my default CloudWatch alarm topic. Now we have a new airing Lambda topic that was created from the serverless deploy using our CloudFormation template. And then if we go to CloudWatch, we have one item in alarm already, actually. So here is our AWS Lambda CloudWatch example, the airing Lambda. We go into it, it is into alarm. And actually, I already actually received an email about it being in alarm. I actually also, when it was deploying, I received the email about my account needing to actually confirm subscription. So I already confirmed subscription. By the way, if you are doing this to your own email, it might actually go into the spam folder. So if you don't see it, check your spam. This is letting me know that my AWS CloudWatch example went into alarm. So there you have it. You just learned how to have a Lambda function that has a CloudWatch alarm attached to it. And you've learned how to do it using the AWS console as well as utilizing serverless framework. Actually, really, you've learned how to do this using the CloudFormation template. So if you liked what you saw, please remember to subscribe to my channel to get other AWS tutorials and occasionally some programming tips and tricks as well. And until next time, happy learning.